Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, my name is Tawfiq Chaudhary. I'm the Director General of Al-Kawthar Institute and Mercy Mission. It gives me tremendous pleasure to announce to you, inshallah ta'ala, our Knowledge Hive, which will be running in Toronto from the 7th of July until the 13th of July, inshallah ta'ala. If you will remember, if you attended my last course that I did, which is The Real Deal in Toronto, I told you that the Knowledge Hive is coming your way. And bi-idhnillah, alhamdulillah, the teams have been very busy preparing, planning, and a lot of work has gone behind the scenes preparing for it. And inshallah ta'ala, it is absolutely wonderful to be able to announce it to you today that inshallah ta'ala, Knowledge Hive is coming your way. UK, we started the Knowledge Hive, which lasted for about 8 days, in one of the more secluded areas of UK, and in one of the Muslim hostels there, which was in a nice wilderness area. And it was a really nice experience. What we did was the students would come, obviously it was residential retreat, so we would wake up in the morning at 6 o'clock, and in the freezing cold we would go out. It was actually cold at that time, obviously it's December so it's cold, and so we would go out to pray Fajr at 6 o'clock in the morning. Then Fajr would finish by 6:30, straight away off to class. We would start the class by 7 o'clock in the morning, then we would stop at 8. After 8 we would have breakfast until 8:30 or 9, and then after that would be classes all the way till 1, and then after that would be break for 1.5 hours or 2 hours, then classes again, and then after that another break where we would have you know, lots of various activities, you know, soccer games, table tennis matches, you know, basketball games, you name it, and then thereafter we would go back to class again, and then of course only interrupted by prayer all the way up until almost 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock at night. Imagine studying for 10-11. Is that possible, and is that realistic? I mean, why is Al-Kawthar even doing this, knowing that people's attention span cannot be more than that? Well, there's a number of reasons why we're doing it this way. By the way, it doesn't finish at 10, because after 10, then all these private sessions start, because all the students, they want to come across, and so the brothers sit with the mashayikh, and the sisters have their own private sessions, and they all talk all the way up until almost 12, 1 o'clock at night, and then they go to sleep, only to wake up 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock next day. And this went on for 7 days or 8 days. And it's quite interesting. Why is it that Al-Kawthar is doing this? Is there a reason behind it? Yes, because ultimately the Knowledge Hive is not just a retreat where it's a holiday for a week. No, my intention, inshallah, and the intention of the brothers and sisters running Knowledge Hive is to give you a time away from a busy 9-to-5 schedule where you're working only for this dunya, into where you have 1 week where you're working only for the akhirah, where all you're doing is spending time remembering Allah, hours and hours talking about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of its issues, of its matters, of its creed, its methodology, its hadith, its tafsir, its seerah, its history, and its biographies of the scholars. And all you're doing is discussing all of that, and you're cleansing your heart at every single point. You see, the Knowledge Hive was a tarbiyah experiment, and indeed it is so. It is a tarbiyah session wherein we spiritually refine ourselves, both our minds by increasing it with knowledge, and our hearts by cleansing it from all the filth and the evil and the harm that has become filled inside it because of our day-to-day life struggling for this dunya. And inshallah ta'ala, also the physical part of it, which is waking up so early in the morning for Fajr and then all the way till late at night and only sleeping for a small amount of time, is a tarbiyah session to re-energize your batteries. Because I always say, you know, a Muslim must become more effective, more productive, and more efficient with his time, right? And so with this practical tarbiyah, sleeping only about 4 or 5 hours and studying the whole day and then talking about the deen and starting of the day with your with Quran and with memorizing and with tarbiyah and cleansing of your heart and tasfiyah of your soul, it becomes the perfect 1 week retreat, the perfect 1 week Muslim holiday in a nice residential retreat wherein you're sitting around with all your friends and all your bosom buddies. You become close and you become very good friends with them. And on top of that, of course, you get to be with all the instructors. Unfortunately, in the weekend courses, you can never really be with us, can you? You can, you know, ask us a question here and there, and well, alhamdulillah, you know, praise be to Allah if your question is ultimately answered with so many students there. But here in the Knowledge Hive, the numbers are restricted intentionally. And also what we do is that we keep that one-to-one attention. We become friends with each other. After the Knowledge Hive, every single brother and sister, I know them by name. After the Knowledge Hive, I know their background. I know them, and they know me even more detail. I get an opportunity to sit with them and to talk to them at length. And I make it a policy in the Knowledge Hive that not a single question goes unanswered. So this is what the Knowledge Hive is. It's an opportunity to be with your brothers and sisters, talking about the deen from the morning till the night, having a session to improve your time management skills and to retrain your body into working more for the hereafter and less for the dunya, and be content with less. And also it's a time to have a lot of energizing activities, which is coming your way, inshallah ta'ala, in the Knowledge Hive.